All right, so in the previous video, we talked about how you can shade this stuff. Very relatively easy way of shading this thing. So we talked about it, and we talked about how you can use the emission to drive something like this wax that we have here, which is giving us this very extremely nice feel. You know, we talked about this, and we also talked about how you can, you know, connect something like label to get a much more richer feel directly inside your object. And then we went on to, you know, talk about how you can drive this by using some sort of transparency and all that. Okay, so now what we're going to do is, how can we, you know, set up certain things around here. So for this one now, I am thinking that we can also just simply add one extra node. So I can come through and add a utility node, I think. So we can use a utility node and actually do a color adjust. All right. So I want to use this color adjust to drive this opacity. All right. So I want the color adjust to be used to drive the opacity. Right now, I would go ahead and turn the saturation down. So by turning the saturation down, what I'm essentially doing is taking away all the color information I have just to stay with a simple gray. So if I turn the saturation up, it becomes very, very saturated, right? So I can turn the saturation down. I can turn the value. So if I turn the saturation down, I can turn the value up, and I can also turn up the contrast. Okay. All right. I actually think I should have gone the other way around. So if I pick this and start adding a couple of brown or a couple of gray, if I start adding a couple of gray, you see we're beginning to get a much more nicer looking light out of this thing. And everything is going on fine. In the previous video, we talked about how we added the bump. So you can check that out in case you want to follow up with what we have right now. So next thing which we want to do is, you know, put a backdrop to this object. So I'm just going to go ahead and go over. All right. So we're going to add a backdrop. We're going to add a volumetric light. And then finally, we would, you know, just do a little bit of housekeeping and then render. Right. Okay. So this is what we want to go for. So I'm going to go over to edits. And within the edits, I would like to throw in a simple backdrop. So we have this object where we want it to be, and we have every thing according to the scale that we want it to actually have, right? So we have a candle, we have a backdrop. Then the next thing which we need to do is start lighting this stuff. By default, what we have here is a very simple and nicely done light, and you can check that from the environment. Now once you go over to the environment, you'll notice that we have a startup light. In case you don't know how or where this startup light comes from, how you can do that is if you come through to window library and we go over to the materials directly here, let's allow this to load. You would see that we have different kinds of HDRI. And these HDRIs is what Keyshot actually makes use of when it's about to start rendering your stuff. So it uses the HDRIs to render your stuff properly. All right. So what we're going to do is we can go in and throw in a couple of lights to get a different feel of the object. So if I click on any of them and throw them in, we'll have a different feel. All right. So you can choose from a wide variety of existing ones to get something looking nice. Okay, so let's say we want to stick with this. Okay, so if you want to make changes, you can also come through and make changes and, you know, position the light how you want it to be within your scene. This is just one of those things that makes Keyshot stand out, right? One of those amazing things that makes Keyshot stand out. So you can, you know, play around and get whatever you want. And once you've made these changes, you can press this button to actually make it recalculate properly for you. So now we have all of this beautiful, lovely thing going on. what we would want to do is to throw in some volumetrics. Okay, so you can choose to throw in various volumetric lights. So for this volumetric, what I would like to do is I'm going to go ahead and create something that looks like a dome. And because I would like to return back to this part, I will come through and create a new camera within this part and store that camera. All right, I'm storing this camera so I don't need to go back and forth to get this thing working again. Okay, so I will come here, go over to edit, add geometry, and I'm going to add, let's say, a big cube. All right, so I'm adding a big cube around here, and now if I have this cube selected and scale this cube a little bit more, you would notice. So I'm just going to select this cube and position this cube here. You would notice that it's just a simple cube. Now see what happens if I come over to the material and let's double click this material for the cube, says cube material, and change this to scattering. You would notice that it's beginning to scatter points around this object, right? So I can throw in different forms of scatter directly into this object, various points of scatter, right? So I can throw in different kinds of scatter directly into this cube object. So what I would like to do is I would like to multiply this scatter so that it might be a bit too much. Actually, I shouldn't multiply that. I will turn down the density and also increase the transparency distance between these things. I will zoom all the way out because we already have our camera stored. So I'm going to go jump back to free camera and I'm going to zoom all the way out. Okay, so now I'm all the way out. I would go ahead, select this object and scale. So now I have this thing scaled all the way out. The next thing which I will do, right? The next thing which I will do is to come over to this material and let me just turn this density a little bit low, right? So I'm turning down the density so that I will be able to see what's going on in the scene. So I'm just going to turn down this density just about that point. So if I switch back and let me make this somewhat, it's blue, blue looks good, maybe not so thick blue. So if I jump back to the camera, jump back to this point, flip back to the free camera, you would notice we're having a very nice looking space here. So I'm just going to turn this down and let's turn this a little bit more, and there you can see we're having this volumetric scatter happening here. All right, so if you want to make this totally white, it's up to you. You can make it totally white. If you want to go ahead, let's give it a chance. If you want to go ahead and switch this to something that is a bit more purple-like, so maybe something purple-like like this, it is, you know, totally up to you and whatever thing you want to make. So you can add volumetrics directly here, and you can still control this volumetrics by adding extra light features. I'll show you how. So now we have done this, I'm just going to click on OK just to get that out of the way. I can come over and add something I would use to control the light. Changing this to area light. All right. Previously, this was all we had. Okay. But now there is a feature that exists that you can now pick a spotlight. And you know, you can now attach that spotlight to an object and automatically there is a spotlight. You can also choose to, you know, mix the spotlight. You can see with all this very interesting looking stuff that we have here. So you can choose to mix the spotlight to create very interesting looking shapes around this, or you can just simply go ahead and use the previous one, which is the one which we had here. Right, so I'm opting for this particular one, so that's why I'm going to go ahead and use it. So I just wanted to show you guys, so just in case you don't know that it existed before, you can have a good idea. All right, so now I have this. I'm just going to turn up the cube and double click, go into where I have this cube, and now turn this density a little bit more. Now this is a bit too much, right? I'm just going to turn this density a bit low. I think this is a little bit too much, so I can turn this down. Density a little bit low, and let's also turn, let's turn up the transparency distance so it could be more transparent over time. All right, so now we have this going for us. Within this part where I have the texture which is driving this plane, so I have this light texture which is driving this, I can come here and say I don't want you to output from the other side. Okay, so I want the output to be from one side, so I can just simply turn up the side where I want the output to be from. So I don't want it to output from the back, but I want it to output from the front, or I don't want it to output from the front. Then I can go ahead and choose the back. All right, if you want it to be visible to reflections, fine. If you want it to be visible and, you know, in shadows, of course you can go ahead and do all of that stuff. So now we have this thing going for us. The next thing which I'm going to do now is I would go ahead and reduce this scale a bit, reposition this. So let me just make sure I'm here. So this is good. And then once we have all of this going, we can choose to say don't be visible to the camera, so we would not be able to see where the light source is coming from. And the same thing goes for this one. We don't want to see this. We don't want to see where the light source is coming from. We can go to the camera, jump in, and, you know, select our camera position, and we can get that going for us. So this is how you can play directly inside Keyshot to get what you want. So I'm going to allow this to start rendering while I talk about some other things. So while this is going on, you can choose to let me turn this open. Okay, so you need to let this loose. You can choose to add some depth of field if you are particular with depth of fields, and if you want a lot of depth of field or you like those things, you can turn this on. You can go over to the image tab here, and within the image you can choose to add some image adjustments like the bloom, for example. You can also choose to add some chromatic aberration. I kind of like the aberration a little bit more, so you can punch in the chromatic aberration. And since we're here, I would like to make changes to the position of this thing. So I would like to make changes. Let me just rotate this a little bit forward. Maybe a little bit forward would be fine. All right, good. So you can go ahead and make changes. You can use the dolly to actually dolly this properly. All right, so you can make changes to whatever thing you want to make. So I'm going to add a bit of chromatic aberration, just a little bit more, and a little bit of the vignette. So I'm just turning this back on. I'm going to add some vignetting around this. And I guess that's about it. Let's make sure we have everything we want. The bloom looks good. Exposure is fine. Exposure is fine at whatever value it is. So once you're comfortable with everything you're doing, you can go ahead and fire up the render. All right, so basically this is how we can shade a candle in the wind directly here in Keyshot. So what we can do finally is just, you know, simply go over and hit the render button. So we can just hit the render button and render this totally out, and, you know, use it for whatever thing which we want. And if you want to render in Keyshot, but my best advice is always make sure that you set up whatever you want. So set up the size that you want to render as, and, you know, you can also set the samples. Okay, so if you want to get render passes directly from here, I kind of used only the clown pass, not that much, but just the clown pass is enough for me, because, you know, you can go ahead and make other tweaks. You can also choose to increase the sampling size. So right now it's set to 64. You can choose to increase the sample size to maybe 128 is always nice. And, you know, once you're done, you can, you know, just hit the render button and add it to the render queue. And if you like this video, I would like you guys to hit the like button and also turn on the notification. And if you want to watch more videos here, hit the subscribe button and also don't forget to turn on notifications so you get updates once we upload a new video. And until I see you guys again with a tutorial update, review, tips and tricks, things like this, peace.